Hello and welcome back to Lights, Camera, Nudo. I'm one of your hosts, Caden. There are two other hosts, CJ and Joey. This week is the last day of Lights, Camera, Nudo. So we have more fun and awesome segments planned. So let's get into it. It's Spilling Tea with Cassidy.
Hello. And welcome back to Spilling Tea with Cassidy for the last time, which I am so sorrowful about. But this is a debating segment, so I'll give you guys a debate. Today we will be debating about our favorite foods. Today, my special guest is Rosalie Sardino from Word of the Week.
Hi, it's Rosalie from your favorite segment.
Hey! Anyway, let's get into it. I like pickles the best because they are delicious and the best tasting food in the whole wide world.
Well, I think that pizza is the best because it is also delicious, and scientists recommend you eat it for breakfast because it has vegetables, and vegetables have nutrients, so it's good for you.
Pizza for breakfast? That's just revolting. I like pickles better because they have everything. The cucumber they're made out of, and that little bit of salt. That's the whole package right there.
Well, I think that your opinion is the worst one around.
Hey, I think your opinion is uncivilized, miss.
Okay, well then.
Hey, what was that for?
You, because your opinion is subpar.
But pickles are the best. Hey, I was gonna drink that. Well, that's the end of Spilling Tea with Cassidy. Thank God, because I don't like getting tea spilled on me. That's the end of my segment, grand finale, and bye guys!
Whoa, Cassidy, that's the third time that happened. Anyway, next up is Fun and Games with CJ and Caden.
Hello and welcome to Fun and Games.
Here we talk about video games.
I'm CJ.
And I'm Caden.
And the topic for this week is the Minecraft 1.16 update, better known as the Nether update.
In the Nether update, they released many new mobs, blocks, and biomes, but there are way too many to list, so we'll just list our favorites.
For blocks, our favorites are the lodestone and the respawn anchor. The lodestone allows you to pretty much set a waypoint using a compass, while the respawn anchor allows you to set your spawn point in the Nether.
Our favorite mobs are the piglin and the strider. The piglin is pretty much a bipedal pig that takes you on and gives you something random in return. The strider, on the other hand, is just a red block with legs that you can ride across lava.
For our favorite biomes, one of them is the Soul Sand Valley, which is an area full of sand that slows you down in blue fire. Oh yeah, and there's also giant bones sticking out of the ground and ceiling.
For our other favorite biome, it is the Basalt Delta, full of spiky rocks and magma cubes.
This update also added a brand new resource that is better than diamond, the material that stood number one for almost 11 years. And this resource is known as netherite.
The way that you can get netherite is by mining ancient debris, smelting it in a furnace to get netherite scraps. And then you take four netherite scraps, put it in a crafting bench with four gold ingots, then you get one netherite ingot.
And then you use one netherite ingot and one piece of diamond gear in a smithing table to turn that diamond gear into netherite gear. We hope you enjoy the final segment of Fun and Games.
Yay, the Minecraft update! Well, let's waste no time and go right into Eating with Ella.
Welcome back to the last Eating with Ella. Today, my special guest is Lorelai from Murphy with Lorelai.
Hello!
So let's get right into it. Oh wait, I have to tell you what this is and how it works. Today, we're going to be doing another challenge called the Throw Together Challenge. Here's how it works. Miss Teresa went out and bought 9 food items for us to make something out of. We have to take at least 4 and make something. We have a limited time to make something.
I wonder what the ingredients are.
Me too.
Can we get started now?
Oh yes, the ingredients are on that tray. 3, 2, 1.
Whoa.
Okay, so we have apples, cheese sticks,
sugar,
cinnamon, pepperoni, Nutella,
cream cheese,
tortillas, graham crackers, and garlic powder.
So let's get started.
3, 2, 1, go.
That was a crazy throw-together challenge, Ella. So now, it's time for Words with Rosalie.
Welcome to the last word of the week. I'm Rosalie, and back with me today is Jane. Our first word of the week is serendipity. That means a series of events by chance in a happy or beneficial way. Let's use it in a sentence. Thanks to some serendipity, the New Deal Creative Arts Center was created. Our next word is humorous. That means a humorous writer, performer, or artist. Let's use it in a sentence. Mark Twain was a famous and loved humorist. See you soon. Have a great summer. Bye.
Hello, I am CJ Harriman, and I'm one of the co-hosts for this week's episode of Lights, Camera, New Deal. Today we have a special guest for our interview. I'd like to welcome Hyde Park Supervisor Rohr. Thank you for joining us today, Supervisor Rohr.
Well, thank you so much for inviting me. It's my pleasure to participate.
So I've put together some questions to ask. So if it's okay with you, let's get started.
That sounds great.
So first, can you please tell us what the responsibilities and duties of the town supervisor are?
The first responsibility and primary responsibility as defined by New York State town law is fiscal. Town supervisors are the chief fiscal officers for their town, which means that we have the responsibility of managing the budget, which then, of course, the budget is what generates people's taxes. But in addition to managing the budget, we also are charged with managing the expenses and making sure that we get the best bang for the taxpayer's buck. And so that's the primary responsibility. And because Hyde Park is a big town, we're 22,000 people, and we have a lot of departments, one of which is the police department, it's a pretty complex task to make sure that all of these services are operating optimally to service the public. But an additional responsibility of a town supervisor is really to manage the appropriate growth for a town and to get involved with creating a vision and a dream for what you want your town to be. So those two things keep all town supervisors very busy.
That sounds like it's a pretty hard job.
Well, I would agree it is. But, you know, I love it. I love my work. And I'm president of the Dutchess County Mayors and Supervisors Association, and I can guarantee everyone who lives in Dutchess County that they have impassioned leaders at the top who love their towns and want to do the hard work to make it their communities a great place to live.
Yeah, that makes sense. So how long have you served as supervisor of Hyde Park?
Well, this is my ninth year, and that shocks me. I never expected to be doing this for this length of time. I was elected in, I took over in January of 2012.
That's even longer than a president can serve for.
That's a good observation. That's true. But, you know, I am reelected every 2 years, so the people have their say. And so I feel really proud that I'm able to serve my hometown where I grew up and I raised my family, and that the people support me and seem to like the work that I'm doing.
All right. So what made you interested in being town supervisor?
Well, I had been involved with a number of volunteer committees and had, you know, over the years learned how town government operates. And I believed and continue to believe that I had good things to contribute to lead our town. And it turns out that it's a great fit for me. But it was really an evolving sense of wanting to effectuate a change and to bring a vision to life in the town.
Okay. So what's your favorite part of being supervisor?
I'm sorry, could you repeat that?
What is your favorite part of being the town supervisor?
My favorite part, I would say there's two parts to that question. The first is that I love the creativity of it. And I love the problem solving aspect to it. And I especially love bringing people together and meeting new people and combining those skills to serve the town in the best of our ability. So, you know, it's a hard question to answer because there's so many parts of it that are combined, but essentially, the people are really motivating for me, including the public, serving them, finding out what they want to see in their town, and working with all the great people at town hall, at the county level, the state level. There's a lot of collaboration that goes on and forging connections between different layers of government to make things happen or to solve problems is a great pleasure for me.
Wow. What is something you're most proud of during your time as supervisor?
I'm really proud of the management that we've done of our town, that we have for 9 years been a cohesive town board that has worked closely with our partners to find the common ground and to manage our town in a fiscally responsible way. When we took over in town hall, we had towns have what they call fund balances. They're like your savings account, and every town is required to have one. And it's where the town can go during a rainy day. And, you know, if you need funds for extra salt or for new machinery or create a new system, you know, to address problems within our infrastructure. And so we have these fund balances. You have one for the highway department and one for your general fund. And when we first came into town hall, there was a negative fund balance in the highway department and a very small fund balance saving account for the town general fund. And so we've been able to, through careful fiscal management, add substantially to those fund balances and create special funds within them for future needs, such as I mentioned, highway needs, or to provide retirement benefits. And so I'm very proud of how carefully we've managed the town's budget while still making improvements like new sidewalks various improvements to our town buildings, and we've been able to buy new snow plows and we've been able to fix roads. And so those are things that make me feel really good about the work that we've done.
Sounds like you're pretty good with money.
I think that's a good observation. I like to think so.
All right. So what are your hopes or future goals for Hyde Park?
So, they remain actually the vision that we came into town hall on, and that's really to create a more vibrant commercial center in our town. And, you know, we have great neighborhoods, we have amazing trails, we have fantastic parks, we have excellent schools, we have all these great things. But one thing that Hyde Park has lacked is a vibrant downtown, like a commercial center where people can get the things they need, or where we can provide interesting places for tourists to go. So, that was really what we ran on, and it's what we've worked really hard on. That's this vision that I talk about, and that's to create a more vibrant town center. So we actually have a website called HP Downtown, and it kind of lays out all the work that we've been doing. So, you know, there were three components to this this vision. The first was pedestrian, creating stronger pedestrian links to forge connection between businesses and neighborhoods. So we've done good work there, and that's still in the process. We've obtained grant funding to build new sidewalks, to put in pedestrian level lighting, and we have an additional grant that we're working on right now to bring that new pedestrian link further to the north, to create a better connection to the plazas up there. And so that's, you know, an ongoing work, is these improving the pedestrian links of the town. And we've been very successful in that endeavor. We've built five or six sidewalks over the last years, and they're all well used by the public. But then the second part is this, the need to create the sewer infrastructure, the wastewater treatment, so that people can have dense housing and dense commercial entities. And that's been an effort that's a lot more difficult to achieve because it's very expensive, and it's only those people within this sewer district that can pay for the infrastructure. And so we've gotten a lot of grants to create these engineering plans and advance this project. And it's about a $23 million project, and it would have to be paid for by 108 people. So it's very expensive. And so, yeah, we were able to get $5 million in commitments. We got state monies through grants. We got monies from developers. But yet that $5 million was not enough to make it affordable for those 108 people. So that's second part of our downtown initiative. And we're kind of putting that on the shelf till we can come up with additional funds to make that per parcel cost lower. And then the third thing is to one of the functions of the town is to have zoning, which controls how properties can be built out and what kind of uses can go there. So what we did is we received grant funding to modernize our zoning and create new town core zoning, which we are about to pass or to vote on at the town board. So, you know, those three components are what we have worked hard to bring this vision of a vibrant center to fruition, and they're still a work in progress.
That sounds like it'd be pretty nice.
That was a long answer, I know, but it is a complicated process to create change. You know, in life, it's kind of easy to be opposed to something, but to actually create something good takes a lot of effort, a lot of time, and a lot of collaboration between people. And so that's where we are with our efforts, and they will continue, and we will continue to do that hard work.
All right. So lastly, how can the youth of Hyde Park contribute to the town?
That is a wonderful question, and you know, they already do. We have a number of committees that maintain our roadways, and one is a Hyde Park Visual Environment Committee, and they're always looking for volunteers. You'll see them alongside the roadway in various times. You'll see them in the fall planting daffodil bulbs. You'll see them in the spring cleaning up the garbage that gets disposed of on our roadways. So they are always looking for volunteers. And in fact, they work closely with the Chamber of Commerce, Bob DeLarm, who does very similar work. And we often have Boy Scout troops that plant flowers at the war memorial. So there's lots of opportunities for the youth to actually make physical improvements to the town. And that's always really satisfying. We also have a trail committee. And as I mentioned earlier, we have numerous trails throughout the town. And that trail committee, they put together work days. And so the youth in Hyde Park would be really, we would love to see them join in on those efforts. I think the other is a more political or esoteric, well, you know, come on up to the town board meetings and follow what we're doing. And who knows, you may want to run once you get to be a voting age, you may want to run for a town board position or serve on a committee. You know, we have numerous committees at the town level, and we welcome input, especially from people that will be living in our town in the future. So I think those are two really nice ways that the youth could get involved.
Yeah, that was a lot of great information. Thank you so much for joining us today. We appreciate your time, Supervisor Rohr.
You're so welcome, and I appreciate your interest. And thank you, and wishing you guys a wonderful school year ahead, and continue the good work.
And thank you for your service to Hyde Park.
You're so welcome.
And now we will move on to a word from our sponsors. Hey parents, we have an important message for you.
We know we keep you busy, we know we make you tired, but we want you to know we care about you.
We want you to stay healthy, we want you to live a long time, and this means you have to take care of yourself and your health.
So take a look at Mike Ortega's Health and Fitness Center. They have so many ways for you to make exercise a permanent part in your life.
Owner and founder Mike Ortega has been running a gym since 1973. That's a super long time. He must know what he's doing.
He offers cardio, strength training classes, free weights, and hey, they even have cardio cinema.
You mean you can watch a movie while working out? That's cool.
There are two convenient locations in Poughkeepsie and Highland, and both have a pool for us to go swimming together in. You're running out of excuses.
Contact Mike Ortega today for more information.
Thank you for supporting New Deal Kids, Mike Ortega.
If it's a hot summer day and you want to treat yourself, go to Nana's Ice Cream and Grill.
We can get all kinds of ice cream, like Cookie Monster,
coffee,
cookies and cream,
cannoli, Queen of Hearts,
and stacks like Minstack.
Don't forget the peanut butter explosion.
If you're looking for lunch or dinner, Nana's menu has something for everyone.
Like burgers, hot dogs, tacos, wings, quesadillas, chicken nuggets, french fries, meatball subs, grilled cheese, mac and cheese bites, shaved ice, fried Oreos, salads, Philly cheesesteaks.
That's enough, CJ!
Nana's is Hyde Park's friendly neighborhood summer hotspot located on Route 9G.
Hey, that's right down the road from New Deal.
When you and Nana's, you're not just a customer, you're a friend.
Well, let's go straight into the review.
Hello and welcome back to the Review with Lorelei. I've reviewed a movie based on the 80s. I've also reviewed a TV show based on the 80s. So this week I'll be reviewing a hit song based on the 80s, I Wanna Dance With Somebody. So let's get right into it. I Wanna Dance With Somebody came out on May 2nd, 1987. The person who sings this song is National Treasure Whitney Houston. Whitney Houston's first single was I Wanna Dance With Somebody. The highest it went on the Billboard Top 100 was number 3, but it was on the Billboard chart for 11 weeks straight. My review is that this is a great song, and I love it because it has a great beat and because I love to dance. Listening to it. Thanks for joining me on the Review with Lorelei. Bye, everyone!
Wow, Lorelei, that was an amazing review. But now it's time for Magic with Kaden.
Hello, and welcome back to Magic with Kaden. This week, I'll be doing... Actually, I don't know what it's called. Anyway, Jane, can you bring my cup? This is my assistant, Jane. Now that I've done the trick, I can tell you the secret. Now let's hope no one interrupts us this time. So, the secret is... Well, I guess that's the season finale of Magic with Kaden. Bye! How'd that get there? Well, a magician never reveals his secrets. Now let's go into Drawing with Joey.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the final episode of Drawing with Joey. Because it's our final episode, I will be having not one, not two, but three special guests. They are Cassidy.
Hi, I'm Cassidy from Spilling Tea with Cassidy, your debating segment.
CJ.
Hey, I'm CJ from Fun and Games.
And Ella.
Hi, I'm Ella from your segment, Eating with Ella.
All right, that's everybody. Today, we will be drawing a yellow bunny.
Oh, that's easy.
Oh, wait. Blindfold. We will be wearing blindfolds while we're drawing, though.
What?
What now?
Yep. Okay, now, everyone put on your blindfold so we can get started. All right. Now, start the time.
How much time do we have?
25 seconds.
What? Not enough.
I never said it was going to be easy.
Okay, I guess you're right.
Now draw! everyone's drawings. All right, I'll be now we must decide who the winner is. Okay, I've decided that the winner is Cassidy.
Yay!
Thank you for watching our final episode of Drawing with Joey. Goodbye.
Bye.
And that was our show. Thank you for watching everyone perform. We had a lot of fun doing this, and we hope you enjoyed it.